5 days after an electric vehicle destroyed 140 vehicles in a parking garage in Korea, there was a second Korean parking garage fire involving an electric vehicle. This one went a little bit differently. This fire occurred on August 6, 2024, and the outcome is significantly different than the fire in my last video. This involved a Kia EV6, and it uses a battery that I'm extremely familiar with. It's an 800-volt system using 30 to 32 battery modules. Each battery module uses pouch-style cells. The owner of this vehicle actually stated he plugged this vehicle in to charge it around 7 p.m. the night before, and the fire broke out at 5 a.m. Fire crews were alerted when residents noticed the vehicle was smoking, off-gassing that flammable toxic gas. When fire crews arrived, they were initially trying to cool the battery from underneath using a pancake-style nozzle, flowing water at the underside of the battery. This is something that is worth trying, but it really depends on vehicle construction. A lot of these vehicles, you have layers of material between the underside of the vehicle to the battery cells themselves. You have to protect those battery cells from impact. This specific vehicle, you have a thermal management system that's between the bottom side of the vehicle, the exposed surface that they're spraying this water on, and the batteries themselves. So it's something that I don't see as 100% effective. And you can tell it's not effective because after a while of spraying water underneath that vehicle, it actually does burst into flames. Fire crews are very fortunate because they're actually on scene applying water to this vehicle when it transitions from that off-gassing phase to the fire phase. Likely this vehicle next door where they're trying to protect that exposure, put water on the vehicle, is going to be damaged, but not catastrophically damaged. One interesting thing about the EV6, it does not have traditional deflagration vents. They actually use the seal between the tray and cover as a sort of blowout valve when there's some type of thermal runaway event in the battery. The fire really can come out anywhere around that battery, so there's no specific point where those gases, where the flame is going to exit the battery. There's a few critical safety aspects I'd like to point out with this video. There's a major safety concern I have with crews operating in this area. Anybody around this vehicle, anybody in this parking garage, should be wearing full PPE with their SCBA on air. They should not be breathing in the toxic gases coming off of this vehicle. You see multiple people in this video wearing just like an N95 mask. That is not going to protect you from the hazards of this battery. Overall, crews limited the damage to this garage. It doesn't appear things got hot enough for the sprinkler system to activate if there was a sprinkler system active. I suspect because this vehicle was on charge for so long that it was likely at 80 to 100% state of charge, depending on the settings of that specific vehicle. Eventually, fire crews were able to get that vehicle outside of the parking garage, wrap it in a fire blanket, and render it safe. As always, I have to remind you that a fire blanket will not extinguish an electric vehicle fire. It won't stop thermal runaway, but what it will do is contain the fire to the battery, not allow other components, the plastics, the carpets, to burn in the vehicle, at least not burn very well. So it kind of keeps everything in check. It protects exposures. So there's a lot of advantages, or there can be a lot of advantages to a fire blanket. You also have to realize that potentially if that battery is still off-gassing, you're building up flammable gas underneath that fire blanket, and you could have a fairly energetic event. One thing you see in a lot of different spaces, parking garages being one of them, are fire extinguishers. They're mandated by fire code. In commercial buildings, you're mandated to have fire extinguishers every so many feet within the structure. You're starting to see those types of codes and regulations when it comes to parking garages involving electric vehicles. And not for fire extinguishers, but actual fire blankets staged near these electric vehicle charging stations. And that's where this product from EV Safety comes in handy. They have a steel cabinet that can safely store a fire blanket near these electric vehicle charging stations. When the fire crews get on scene, they get to the charging station, to the incident, they already have a pre-staged fire blanket ready to go that's near the incident. Any department involved in an incident like this, once that vehicle's been removed from the structure into a safe location or safer location, it's covered in a blanket like this. When the salvage company comes, when that tow truck comes and you load that vehicle onto the tow truck, as it's driving away, you really should have a fire apparatus follow that vehicle all the way to the salvage yard, just in case there is a secondary fire, because there's always that risk of a secondary fire, especially if you don't end up letting that vehicle burn. If you haven't seen my video on the other Korean fire that just happened 5 days ago, check out this video right here.